One of my favorite things to do has always been to try and build real life houses in The Sims. Like, you see a house on the street and you're like, wow, I want my Sims to have that. I'm gonna try and recreate it. I'm obsessed. I always have been. But recently, I've been looking at a bunch of house plans, like drawings of houses and floor plans and stuff, and I kind of like to try and build those. I've done it a couple times, and today I found another one. I have one complaint though. I mean, this is a beautiful house, right? 4 bedroom, 2 bath, 2,300 square feet, but look at the back. What? So like, while I would love to follow this house plan, I simply cannot get behind this. It just looks so weird. This kind of thing happens in real life all the time. The sides and the backs of houses in real life are oftentimes very ugly. The house itself is pretty big. It's nice. All on one story, you know. I've got a little bonus room upstairs, but I found one that I think is better. It's purple. Now, this image quality is terrible. It's like, it's a very small photo. I mean, look at this. But look how pretty this house is. Only 3 bedrooms, 1.5 bathrooms, but it's so cute. And I think this is more doable in The Sims. Like, I think this is the kind of scale that we can recreate. And so, I'm gonna try and copy this house, like, tile for tile, square foot for square foot, and we're gonna see if we can make this floor plan work, but in The Sims 4. I will, of course, link this house plan down below. This website's just kind of fun to mess around with, to be honest, you guys. Like, I really enjoy this. And again, you can find some kind of weird things like this. I worry a little that it won't translate well to The Sims with, like, windows and colors and stuff, because we don't really have that kind of deep purple siding, but I like it. So we're gonna try. I feel like a lot of times in real life, I don't really like houses that are interesting colors. Like, it seems kind of odd to me, but this one in this deep purple, I kind of want to live there. Like, I'm kind of into it. Although I doubt I will ever live in a house that I will paint purple. This seems like a very Sims 3 house to me. Like, this house would go so well in The Sims 3 because you can customize the siding. It would look beautiful, but we're playing The Sims 4 today. We don't really have that option. Okay, as per usual, I begin with a box. I'm gonna just build the basic shape and then we can try and like adjust it to match the scale of the house in a second. But it looks to me, honestly, I think that's the right scale already. So then there needs to be a 2 wide window here and a 3 wide window here, and then a 2 wide door with a 1 space on the side. Okay, I know you don't care about this. I'm just talking out loud to myself here. Let me get a little balcony porch thing, raise it up about like 3 maybe. I'm also not really feeling the medium walls. I think it's gotta have shorter walls. We can maybe change that in a second, but I'm kind of thinking it needs to be shorter. The back is a lot less complicated. The back literally just has like that. They don't actually have a back of the house image, so we'll have to wing it a little bit, but it's okay. We can do it. Plus, the upstairs floor plan is literally identical, so we can just copy it. Maybe it does need to have medium walls. Maybe it does need to be a little bit taller. I don't know. Okay, I think it's too big. Now that I'm looking at the floor plan again, I'm kind of like, I think we did it wrong. It needs to be skinnier. Like, that looks right to me. It's a big porch. It's kind of fun. Okay, and the roof itself looks like it's a little bit tall. Goes like that. You could have a third story in this house so easily. And like, kind of a decent sized one too. Maybe we could put an attic up there just for fun. It's so tall. This house is so tall. Maybe making it shorter again would be a better, safer bet. I don't know. Oh, we'll figure it out. It's fine. I feel like they have like little tiny dark shingles like this. Is that ugly? I don't think so. I don't know. So here's the other annoying part. We don't really have purple siding. Like, there's gray, there's blue, red, pink. This one's kind of purple. That's like honestly the closest thing we're gonna get to purple, which is I think very disappointing because it's not that like deep rich color that I dream of. You know what? I like it. It's growing on me. All right, let's quickly do this part of the roof. The most important part. Okay, that's fine. I think the roof is too tall. I think we made a mistake, you guys. I'm gonna be honest, and a big one. See, in the real build, there isn't a window right here. I think that's weird. I feel like it needs a window right there. I don't think it looks good. This is so disappointing. I feel like we had such high hopes for this. It is not turning out how I wanted it to. Okay, this is blue, which is not the same as purple. And you're all gonna be like, haha, blue suburban, haha. But like, this deeper color, I feel like is maybe more so the vibe. Yeah, I think so. No, that looks good, right? If I just keep saying it to myself, maybe I'll believe it. It looks really good. You're doing a great job, Kayla. Really, really good. No, I think I like it. I think the side of the house literally only has 1 window. But like, that's not really gonna work for us. I think they've got a back patio there too. I don't believe that it has any roofing on it, but I might put some. Cause they have a door in the picture that comes out like right here. So I feel like it's my responsibility to make something more interesting on the back of this house. See, that looks like all the windows they have on the back in the picture I'm looking at, but I don't agree with this. So what I think I might do is extend it a little bit. We're gonna take some creative liberties here. I think it's necessary. Oh, they have closets because it's real life. That's gonna make the bedrooms a little bit more interesting, it seems like. I might not put closets. I guess we could have like maybe a closet up there, or we could put laundry in this room. We can kind of wing it a little bit because this is The Sims. They don't need closets, and like putting the closet space in would mean the bedrooms are like extra tiny, and that would be weird. So let's have the 1, 2, 3 bedrooms, bathroom, and then some sort of laundry right there. I think that works. And it's a big landing. It's nice. They've got in the real picture, they have like a little sofa in that little nook. We could keep that. Maybe a desk or something, you know? Okay, well that's the house and the floor plan. Let's furnish it. I don't think I agree with their layout for the living room because it looks like they've put a sofa like right there and then like chair, kind of like that, and a TV there. Obviously it's kind of more conversation area centric, but I don't think that makes sense. I think that we can have a real sofa in here. Like we could have like a full on real layout. We don't need to have the sofa like in a weird spot. It's not necessary. This is also a half bathroom with laundry in the real house, but I think we might make this the half bath with laundry and this can be a full bath. So we actually have more space. There's two bathrooms in this house now, two full baths, although we don't have any closets, but that's not my problem. So it's fine. Right now I'm kind of just putting like filler furniture in so we can kind of see like the goal of this layout. I think our house is actually a lot bigger than the real one. Like the downstairs space looks huge compared to theirs. Maybe the living space is a little bit smaller. Like, is that too small to have a dining table back there? We could have a smaller dining table. It feels like there's so much empty space. We could do something maybe more like that. Have a table against the wall. That could work. There's still so much empty space in this whole area. I don't know what to do with it. We'll figure something out. It's fine. How about some nice hardwoods? Wow. Turns out I'm just like building my own dream house. I live in Florida. We don't really have that. Houses here, tile everywhere. I'm not kidding. You'd get like beige tile in the whole house like this. This is like nice beige tile. It wouldn't look this good. In real life, they've got the stove on the island. I wish that we could do that. Like have like a stove, like a range on the island, you know, in The Sims. But obviously all of our stoves have like weird backs to them. But this is so realistic to have the range on the island and like an oven separately. Maybe someday. Maybe someday we'll get our dream. It really is a pretty kitchen, huh? I'm jealous. I'm so jealous. I hate how like I build these Sims houses and I'm like, oh wow. Wouldn't that be nice? My other wish list for The Sims is to have microwaves like mounted on the wall. Because you know how often you have like the microwave above the stove and the microwave like kind of is the range hood? We don't have that in The Sims. I think that'd be really cool if we had that. I don't think we will because they have to like reanimate a bunch of things and stuff like that, but it's on my wish list. I don't know what to do with all my weird empty space. Look how it's just so empty in here. Do I put like an extra love seat or something? I guess maybe we could put two chairs there. I'm gonna use different colors, by the way. I'm just kind of right now putting placers down so we can figure out like what we're actually going for. At least then we'll have a vision, you know? That looks all right, right? Right? That doesn't seem as empty anymore in this whole space. I feel like the room before looked very sad and very empty. I think we're improving. I just want any excuse to use this chair. I'm not kidding. I think I can make it work. I think that's really pretty. I think it's cool. Nice one, Simsy. I'm so talented, you guys. Wow. Just kidding. I'm actually really struggling with this. I don't know how I want to furnish the rest of the house. What about a fish tank? That seems really weird in that space, doesn't it? I got really excited about the idea of a fish tank. Honestly, we could put a fish tank right there in the stair landing. It's really weird, isn't it? But like, wouldn't that be so cool? We could put it by the front door. Oh, maybe the front door is a good idea. This window needs to be here to look good from the outside anyway. So that kind of works. We could do that. Mm-hmm. Yep. Mm-hmm. That's totally fine. It's totally normal. I never use this one. This is the cats and dogs one. It's pretty. I want an excuse to put it in my house. You know the chair where you kind of just like pile stuff on? That's that one. You walk in the door, you're like, oh, I got a bunch of things right there. Because you can't put it on top of the fish tank or anything, so this chair, everything, all the stuff, all the crap, just dump it on the chair. Coats, backpacks, you know, all of it, right there on that chair. I think these shelves in laundry are like the best items in the whole game. I'm not kidding. I'm obsessed with these laundry day shelves. I don't know what it is. I just really, really enjoy them. They're cute. They're so cute. I mean, the plants on them and stuff. I wish that we had this plant separated from it. I haven't painted any of the walls yet. I always do it last. It's like easier for me to visualize what I'm doing if I do it this way. But I realize that it's very annoying because I've just furnished like the entire downstairs. Still no paint on the walls. None of it. Nowhere. To be honest, this is a really nice office space. The stairs in my house are kind of like this. There's like a little nook in the stairs too, but there's no window in the hallway. So it's like not pleasant, and it's also smaller than this, so you couldn't fit a desk there. But like, this is a nice place. Like, I would enjoy to sit here and study. It would probably be kind of loud with people going like up and down the stairs all the time, but like, come on, what a pleasant little area. Okay, I'm jealous of this room. I would have loved a bright pink room like this. Although I wouldn't like having to share with my sister. No offense, Shanna, but All right, I furnished the downstairs. I furnished the upstairs. Now I just gotta figure out the outside. The houseplant has a bunch of flowers down here and like a couple trees. So we have a little bit of freedom with the landscaping because they didn't really like tell us what to do. They do look a little bit like these trees though, which is kind of fun, so we can steal that. You know what we could do? As like an ode to the purple, we could use these outdoor retreat flowers. I never use these. That's actually really pretty too. Oh, I like that. Maybe I'll start using those flowers more often. I feel like I just learned something. I did it. I landscaped. I did it. Let's put some terrain paint down. The little things, you know? I'm trying to decide if I want a fence in the backyard. I don't think I do want a fence in the backyard. I think we'll just leave it open. It would be a lot nicer if it were fenced in, but like, eh. It's not in the picture, so therefore it is not in real life. By real life, I mean in The Sims, by the way. yeah. Sims is real life, right? Right? I have a couple like last minute finishing touches. Number one is this couch that looks like a bench. A couple of like garden pots. We need a mailbox. Some lights on the porch. I think that's fine. I think that's good. We could get a ceiling fan. That could be kind of cute. It's a big porch. You could hang out here now. It's like actually pleasant now with a ceiling fan. I like this house. You know what? It doesn't look exactly like the one that they built. It just never will, you know? No matter how many little details we add, it'll never be as good as the real one. I mean, they have kind of like some things like this. We could add some of this stuff. We could like fancy it up a little bit. This, my friends, is architectural detail. Okay? No, I like that. That's pretty. Okay, see, now I've done it. Now it looks just like the real one. I mean, the real one's just a drawing, but you know what I mean. I really do have a lot of fun doing stuff like this. Oh, no, I don't know what to call it. I hate this part. It's so generic looking. I'm sorry. I tried. Does the plan have a name? Okay, the plan is called Plan 23-821, which is not helpful. 23 Park Street. Listen, whatever. Whatever. It's fine. I hate this part. I got the first comment. I better have gotten the first Okay. I got the first comment. Now I'm happy. This always ends up being way more stressful than I think it's gonna be. It never looks as good as you expect it to. It just, that's the nature of building things in The Sims from real life, is the scaling is always off, the colors are off, the windows are off, everything's just off. You've got a vision and it never comes through just quite how you want it to, but at least, you know what, at least we had fun. I'm gonna go. Please subscribe to me on YouTube. Thank you. Goodbye. Also, we just hit 750,000 subscribers today. That's really cool. So thank you so much. I don't know why you chose to subscribe, but if you did, I'm sorry, but thank you.